Hello everybody and welcome to Drag Racing Today. It's our last show for the season, so sit back and enjoy the ride. We're going to feature the Superstock Bracket from April the 1st at Adelaide International Raceway. As always, joining me on the couch is former Australian Funny Car Champion Geoff Pratt. And Geoff, the Superstock Bracket, they're competing for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy. Tell us a bit about it.
Andrew Rowe was a very good Superstock racer going back many years, Bruce. Andrew, with his brother Wayne, were strong Superstock racers. They campaigned the bracket. Unfortunately, Andrew was taken tragically many years ago, so the Races of Victoria decided to have the Andrew Rowe Memorial Race, and it was a very good race. It's a race that everybody comes out for every year. This year, they just couldn't fit into the Calder schedule, so it was moved to Adelaide, and there was a lot of races over there purely for this, the Andrew Rowe Memorial, so a great race, Bruce.
We're looking forward to some great racing, Geoff. Also on today's show, Sharon LaPira catches up with top door slammer legend Victor Bray, the newly crowned world record holder, and she'll show us how to buy your first drag racing race car. But right now it's time to go to the action. Here's Monica van Riet up in the control tower at AIR with her summary of qualifying in Superstock.
Superstock qualifying at Adelaide International Raceway for the Andrew Rowe Memorial has been full of excitement yet again. 21 entries coming from all over Australia, including Western Australia, Victoria and country South Australia. Now the top 11 entries all running under their indexes and the top four all from Victoria. We caught up with number one qualifier Grant Williams in the pits after qualifying.
Grant, you ran 8.381 there this afternoon, which was 0.479 under your record.
Yes, it was a bit of a shock, and I was shocked myself when the car took off. I knew it was going to go fast, and when I got down to the top end, I sort of pulled the parachute a little bit early, and when I come back and read the time card, I actually had to have a look at it three times, and I realised, yeah, it was true. So I'm absolutely wrapped.
Well, congratulations, and to celebrate, I think we might go grab a cup of coffee from your fancy pot over there before you head out tonight.
The fancy pot's something to do with performance today. I'll leave it at that. Thank you.
Best of luck to Grant Williams in eliminations of Superstock. He's got some tough competition alongside him, however, Les Heinz, number four qualifier, Bruno Cavallo, number three, and also Nick Zarakis, number two. I believe that Nick Zarakis can take this one away. He's had a tough season. He went into the water in the first event. Last event was full of controversy. Nick Zarakis, I think this one's for you.
Thanks, Monica, for the summary of qualifying in Superstock. Let's go now to round one, the first half of the draw for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy.
Yes, thank you, Bruce. Now let's have a look at the first half of the Tectaloy Eliminations Ladder for Superstock. The first pairing we come across, Grant Williams from Victoria taking on Joe Tiani from South Australia.
As we see Wayne Robson from Victoria taking on Ian Brown from South Australia.
And the next pairing, Bruno Cavallo taking on Michael Seville.
Rob DeManuel all the way from Western Australia taking on Travis Curnow from South Australia.
And Bob Sherry and Eddie Vonopevic from South Australia.
Going to be some brilliant runs. Let's move on to the very first pairing, right into the action. Joe Tiani for the Greenhouse Superstores lane, about to take on Grant Williams for the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane.
Now we look to the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane there, Michael, of Grant Williams. He's number one qualifier, taking on number 12 qualifier in the Greenhouse Superstores lane, Joe Tiani.
Going to be a super tough launch from both competitors. Okay, the revs come up for Grant Williams. Ah, look at the launch of Joe Tiani. There comes Grant Williams. Going to be a super stop race.
Mike Shy caught up with the winner, Grant Williams, for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Grant, looks as though you've had a pretty good run for your start there.
I'm absolutely wrapped. I don't know how good the run was. The car wheel spun a lot in the middle of the track, but...
871.
Gee, I didn't know it went that good. I had a lot of wheel spin. I had a quick on and off the throttle, and I picked him up in the top end, and I looked over and I thought, just play it safe, just get in front and beat him. Try and save the car, but I'm wrapped.
A very pleased Grant Williams. As we move on to the next pairing, we have Wayne Robson from Victoria taking on the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane, about to run Ian Brown from South Australia for the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Well, you got it in one there, Michael, and we look at the qualifying positions there. Wayne Robson was qualified in 6th, Ian Brown 17.
Okay, Wayne Robson running the big block Chevy Camaro, back to Ian Brown, the small block Chevy. Ah, will stand in Superstock action. Take a look at this, Monica.
Mike Shy caught up with Wayne Robson for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Wayne, a pretty good reaction from the start, 0.444, and you ran a 9.83. Are you pleased with the way the car's going?
Well, the first run today was excellent. The car just pulled a huge wheel stand and got out really well. We've just fitted new shockers and it really helped on the start line. But the second qualifier, They shut me down on the start line when I was ready to stage. They realised there was a car still on the track, so my tyres went off and the run was wasted. And the exact same thing just happened again then, so someone down there's got a bit of answering to do as far as I'm concerned, because that's twice in two successive races.
A very unhappy Wayne Robson there. As we continue on, we see Bruno Cavello in the Greenhouse Superstores lane running that superb-looking Pontiac, about to take on Michael Saville from South Australia in the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane.
Well, you mentioned the beautiful 298 Pontiac there of Bruno Cavello, Michael, running the Greenhouse Superstores lane. It was actually number three qualifier here today, running 3.5 tenths under the index. Now we go back to Michael Saville there, number 14 qualifier, so the upper hand going to Bruno Cavello.
Yes, Bruno Cavello from Victoria at his only second event with this beautiful-looking Pontiac down here, Monica. Can he take a win in the first round of the Andrew Rowe Superstock Memorial? We're about to find out.
We certainly will as they come into stage now. We see the pre-stage beams on for Bruno Cavello coming into full stage for the green light. Here we go.
Oh, very slick car there for Cavello. Michael Saville chases him on down.
A very convincing win there for Bruno Cavello, running an 8.88 at 230 kilometres per hour. Mike Shy caught up with Bruno for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Bruno, welcome to Adelaide. Great to see this car. And you just finished your run there with an 8.88. How was it?
Lucky. We had a great deal of drama on the start line. Overstaged the car, had to reverse it. And they had the 20-second rule on me, and I think I just got in by the skin in my teeth.
Very lucky there for Bruno Cavello. Let's move on for Rob DeManuel from Western Australia. He's taking on the Greenhouse Superstores lane, about to run Travis Curnow from South Australia. He's in the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane.
Yes, now Travis running the beautiful gold Holden VT Commodore in the Tectaloy lane. Number 21 qualifier in a field of 21. Rob DeManuel, number 11 qualifier today, Michael.
Yes, Rob DeManuel has done extremely well in the beautiful looking Holden Calais. The tree runs down. Look at the launch from Rob DeManuel.
Mike Scheid is with Rob DeManuel for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Rob, you just ran an 8.84 there with a reaction of 0.45. How's it looking for you today?
Well, the field's very tough, and I backed off that time to hold my index as much as I could. So hopefully as the air comes around tonight, we can make this thing run a 40. I'll be happy.
And now it's the last pairing in the first half of Tectaloy Superstock. We have the man, Mr. Eddie Vodopevic, running the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane. And now we're going to Bob Sharon, the A Street Holden Commodore in the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Absolutely, Monica. Two all-time South Australian favourites down here on the racetrack about to do battle. Can the tough Ford Falcon put away the Holden Commodore of Bob Sherry? We're about to find out. Let's have a look at Bob here as he slowly comes in towards pre-stage. Now looking at the tree, fully staged for both races on the green light.
And there goes Bob Sherry, and away goes Mr. Ed.
Big horsepower from the Ford Falcon. Can he reel in Bob Sherry?
Mike Scheid is with Bob Sherry for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Bob, here we go. A great event. You've just run a reaction 0.46, and you ran a 10.35. How was your run?
Oh, the wheel stand was the greatest. All you see is a face full of bonnet. It's fantastic. The 10.3, that's insignificant. No, we won. Obviously, we won.
Well, that's the first half of the draw in round one eliminations in Superstock. And Geoff, Grant Williams from Victoria ran under his index.
Yeah, a great little Mazda. A noisy thing, these rotaries, but well under his index and looking good for tonight, Bruce.
Another Victorian, Bruno Cavello.
Oh, what a beautiful car. Brand new car to the drag racing scene in Australia, fully imported from the States, and a beautiful machine.
All right. We'll take a break here on drag racing today, but when we come back, the second half of round one eliminations in Superstock. Welcome back to Drag Racing Today. The feature bracket on today's show is Superstock. And Geoff, this would have to be the best field assembled in Australia.
The Andrew Rowe Memorial Race brings races from all over Australia, Bruce. It is a great race for them, and it's a tribute to all of those races, how they remember Andrew Rowe, so it's great to see.
All right, we've already seen the first half of round one eliminations. Let's go back racing now. Here's the second half of round one.
That's right, Bruce, it is the second half of round one of the Tech Deloy Eliminations ladder coming up right now for Superstock. The first pairing, Tony Schiavolo taking on Frank Schiavolo, both from South Australia.
As we see Graham Sims from Western Australia taking on Brendan Donaldson.
Also Nick Zarakis and Enzo Domizio.
That should be a brilliant pairing. Athol Burns from Victoria taking on Sev Scarponi from South Australia.
And the final pairing, Les Hines taking on Stevie Rosso.
What a brilliant combination.
Okay, we'll have a look at the first pairing here. Greenhouse Superstore's name is Tony Schiavolo on the small block Holden Sedan, and Frank Schiavolo runs the Tech Deloy Performance Coolant Sedan in this pairing.
Yes, Monica, we see the crew chief there just backing out Frank Schiavolo, but now both entries coming in towards the start line area, a very important factor with drag racing.
Okay, now Tony Schiavolo was number 7 qualifier, Frank was 18, so Tony has got the upper hand in this pairing.
Ah, oh, red light there for Frank Schiavolo, there is no more for Frank.
Well, no, there is not at all. So Tony Schiavolo, I presume he'll back it off. Yes, Tony Schiavolo backs it off. He runs it through with an 11.16 at 146 kilometres per hour. Mark Scheid caught up with Tony Schiavolo for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Tony, congratulations. Frank ran a red light. You took your time leaving with a 0.84, but you ran it with an 11.16. How's it going?
Yeah, it's going really well. We're running low 40s, we're really pleased with the car. I saw the red light and backed off. Hey, it's a win.
A win is a win is a win, as they say, Tony. Now we'll continue on. Brendan Donaldson running the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Yes, Brendan Donaldson about to meet Graham Sims from Western Australia, but look, Simsy hasn't made the start line. In fact, Graham Sims of the number 5 qualifier travelled a long way from Western Australia, yeah, but to no avail. In the meantime, Brendan Donaldson runs down the Wizards Camira. In fact, this is the very last time we'll see Brendo run the Camira. He'll be back with a brand new creation.
And he runs a 9.28 at 2.37.
Let's continue on. Enzo Domizio for the Tech Deloy Performance Coolants lane about to take on Nick Zarakis. But what a burnout from this young gentleman. What a driver.
Well, Enzo Domizio in the Commodore puts on a good show for all the fans out here today. Nick Zarakis from Victoria. He has run 4.5 tenths under the G-Gas Index.
Let me tell you, Monica, Nick Zarakis and Enzo Domizio are always at each other's neck. This is going to be a very interesting race. Let's see who takes it out.
Both G-Gases too.
Okay, full power then. Zarakis leads the way down the racetrack.
Oh, and Nick Zarakis backs out of it. Enzo takes the win 9.01. We'll have a look at the Tech Deloy slow motion replay.
Take a look at this. We see Nick Zarakis leading the way. For some reason, Nick gets out of the race and Enzo goes on by and takes the win. Congratulations to you, Enzo.
Mike Scheid caught up with Enzo for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Lot running on this one, but now it takes you on to round two. How are you going to be for that one?
We'll be ready for it. I don't know what to say. I'm just wrapped. Good to beat Nick. Last time we got disqualified, I don't know what that was over, but this is twice we've beaten him now. Australia's fastest G-Gasser, we beat him.
Enzo Domizio over the moon there in that run. Here's Athol Burns from Victoria in the Super Plus Chevy Camaro, but he's taking on Sev Scarponi, nowhere to be seen.
No, he has not shown up. Now, Athol Burns was number 8 qualifier, Scarponi was 9, and have a look at the launch, Mike.
Absolutely gorgeous for the big Chevy Camaro there. What a launch. And as for Athol Burns, hasn't raced in Adelaide for around about 15 years, but he backs out of the run right here and now.
He does. He saves his index, records a time of 11.39 at 123 kilometres per hour.
As we continue on, we have Stevie Russo taking on the Tech Deloy Performance Coolants lane. One tough Holden hatchback about to take on Les Hines from Victoria.
Now we'll have a look at the qualifying standings here. Les Hines qualified in fourth position, 2 tenths under the index in the Greenhouse lane, and Steve Russo was qualified in 15th.
Les Hines from Victoria, 25 years of experience in superstock racing. Stevie Russo around about 5 years. Have a look at the professionalism here from Les Hines. Full horsepower, he should take the win.
And he does. Les Hines takes this win convincingly with a 9.53, 189 kilometres per hour. Mike Scheid caught up with Les Hines for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Les, to say welcome to Adelaide's one thing, but welcome with a reaction of 0.407 and running a 9.53.
That was a Warren Johnson, mate. The car started to creep in the stage. I'm happy to sit at 450 lights. A 407 is a little fast for us.
Well, the second half of round one eliminations there, and Geoff, what about Nick Zarakis and Enzo Dimizio, the rematch?
Well, we all know the dramas of the last meeting. Boy, these guys, they really got into it again. But the Adelaide guy, Enzo, just blitzed him on the start line, kept it all the way in a really big win. Nick Zarakis went home with his tail between his legs.
Nick not very happy. What about Les Hines, the leader in the championship so far?
Well, Les Hines is running several tenths under his index. Les Hines is a great racer. What can you say? The guy, the car, they've all been around for a long time. Great racers, and what can you expect from good racers?
All right, Geoff, well, we'll get back to Superstock a little bit later in the show, but right now, the top door slammer legend, Victor Bray himself, Sharon's caught up with him. Now, things haven't gone so well for Victor this year, but it all came good in Perth in March in the sixth round of the championship. While he was at AIR preparing for a couple of demonstration passes, Sharon caught up with Victor Bray.
Victor, you held the world record for a long time, but recently lost it to Randy Merrick from the States, who set a new world record at 230 miles per hour with an ETA of 6.10. How did that make you feel?
Yeah, the boys over in the States were working real hard. They're running a class over there. They're allowed to run nitro, but they got their first. Xavier Silva, Randy Merrick's crew chief, rang me at home, told me about it, and had to take it on the chin.
You didn't take it on the chin for long, though. Back in Western Australia the other week, you reset that world record yourself. Congratulations, 233 miles per hour.
Yeah, the conditions were right. It was there. The challenge was there. And, boy, the boys running hard in the States made us work a bit harder. We ran 232, 233, so we stamped our authority on it.
But you're still chasing Adelaide's very own Dave Coote there. He's still sitting at the top of that points ladder.
Yeah, Dave's been running real good. His team have been working hard. They've been running real good this year. So, but he's got to come up to my racetrack, race in my terms, in my air, in my area. So, Dave Coote, we'll see you there.
Looks like that's a challenge, and I think we've got a lot more exciting racing ahead this year in Top Door Slammer.
Sharon there with Victor Bray, back in the hunt for yet another championship. We'll take a break here on Drag Racing today, but when we come back, we'll talk racing overseas and round two eliminations for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy.
This is twice we've beaten him now. Australia's fastest streak, G Gasser, we beat him.
Carry on.
Yes!
Right, time to go back racing now. We've met Victor Bray a bit earlier with Sharon. He's here for a match race against Brett Stevens. So let's go now and have a look at the top door slammer action there, plus round two eliminations in Superstock.
The first round of a three-round match race between Brett Stevens in the Greenhouse Superstores lane take on Victor Bray for the Techtelite Performance Coolants lane.
Now, both guys have come down from Queensland this weekend, Michael, to race against each other here at Adelaide International Raceway.
Absolutely, Monica. And Victor Bray has just reset the world record with Top Door Slammer. So congratulations to you, Victor. There's Marie Bray, Victor's wife, backing him up, making sure everything is A-OK. In the meantime, Brett Stevens brings up the Jack Daniels Studebaker towards the start line area.
Now, we also know Brett Stevens from his Top Fuel Harley-Davidson motorcycle, Michael.
Absolutely, Monica. The guy can ride bikes and he can also drive Top Door Slammer. Let's find out this first pairing who is going to be the Top Door Slammer King in a three-round match race.
Okay, Victor now comes into stage. Heads up start, they both get away.
Have a look at this. Both cars are using the entire track. Brett Stevens comes on strong.
Brett takes number one with a 6.45 at 353 kilometres per hour. Mike Shy caught up with both guys for Mega Power Car Care products.
Well, Brett, welcome back once again to Adelaide. Your reaction at 0.538, you just ran a 6.45 at 219 miles an hour.
All right, we got it back, yeah. We've been struggling a little bit with tyre shake today, and it shook me up pretty bad that first one, but that's good.
Victor, we've just seen Brett there who took out the win, but you had a very tight reaction time against his 5.38. You had a 5.13 and ran a 6.69 and 211 miles an hour.
Yeah, I suppose both of them aren't, those reaction times aren't as good as they should be, but no, it's, you know, we're out here to have a match race, do a bit of testing, and we had a bit of fuel spraying over the bonnet that time. I don't know what it was all about. We better go back and have a look, but no, he certainly ran good. That's his best run of the day, so yes. He's showing us where to head.
Yeah, and I tell you what, guys, the crowd love it.
Yeah, that's good to hear.
Now it's time to have a look at the Techtelite Eliminations ladder for round two of the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy, the first pairing being Grant Williams and Apple Burns, both from Victoria.
As we see Brendan Donaldson and also Tony Cerevolo, both from South Australia.
Les Hines from Victoria taking on Rob DeMamiel from Western Australia.
Bruno Covello taking on Bob Sherry from South Australia.
And the final pairing, Enzo D'Amizio and Wayne Robson.
Should be a brilliant pairing also.
And the first pairing now, Brendan Donaldson smokes up the rear tyres in the Wizards Holden Camira, running the Tectaloy Performance Coolantland. Now we have Tony Schiavello, number 7 qualifier today in the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Yes, Monica, both these guys are great mates off the racetrack, but on the racetrack they are dear enemies, and either one of these drivers would love to take a win this time round. We've got to keep a very tight eye on this. Tony Schiavello can really cut the lights off the start line. Brendan Donaldson, he's a very cool customer. Let's find out and see who takes the win this round.
Well, I've got to give the upper hand to Tony Schiavello. He has run just under his index today, so, and Brendan Donaldson was qualified in 16th position. Okay, Schiavello leaves on a green, both clean greens.
Yes, Brendan Donaldson, bit of a problem there off the start line, but keeps the horsepower on.
Mike Shire caught up with Tony Schiavello, who ran at 10.54 for Mega Power Car Camp product.
Well, Tony, you made it through that one. Reaction time not real quick, perhaps, the 5.51, but you ran a 10.54 for the win at 120 miles an hour.
Yeah, not too bad. I saw Brendo come up. I got off it a little bit, but still my reaction time's a little bit down, but no, it was good. It's a good win.
You're there.
We're there. Thanks, guys.
A very cool Tony Schiavello there. As we move on, we see Bruno Covello from Victoria take on the Greenhouse Superstores lane, driving the beautiful-looking Pontiac.
Yeah, the beautiful 298 cubic inch Pontiac. They're taking on Bob Sherry, running the Tectaloy Performance Coolant lane. Now, both guys have been running under their indexes today. Covello qualified in third position, Sherry in 10th.
Okay, we keep an eye on the start line area. Covello bringing in the small Pontiac. Sherry gets away on the green. Also, Covello, this is going to be a real super tough race.
Well, Covello has to catch up to Sherry and doesn't seem to be able to do that. Bob Sherry takes a convincing win, a 10.11 under the index. Mike Shire caught up with Bob Sherry for Mega Power Car Care products.
Well, Bob, another round through. Reaction time, 0.407, if you don't mind. And then you ran a 10.11, 127 miles an hour.
Unreal, eh? Everyone calls me an old man. How do you like that for a reaction time?
Good.
Good wheel stand. I just love the wheel stands. Even if I lost the race, I still enjoy it. Oh, it's great.
A very happy Bob Abdul Sherry there once again, as we see Rob D'Emanuel from Western Australia about to take on Les Hines from Victoria.
Okay, here's Les Hines here right now in the Greenhouse Superstores lane. Les was number 4 qualifier today. He ran 0.2 under the index, and D'Emanuel was number 11 qualifier.
As we see on board the office there for Rob D'Emanuel, an automatic transmission on board. We go back to Les Hines, running the superb Speed Pro Demolition Camaro, running a 4-speed manual transmission. It's the Jericho.
Okay, both guys fully staged. Green light comes down for Hines. Green light for D'Emanuel. They get away for the drag race.
Ah, oh, Rob D'Emanuel pulls on the power, but Les Hines, who's it going to be?
Rob D'Emanuel takes the win, runs an 8.52. Mike Shire caught up with Rob D'Emanuel for Mega Power Car Care products.
Rob, I think you'd be fairly pleased with that run. Reaction time, 0.481, and you ran an 8.52. Were you happy with it?
Yeah, but you got to tell me if I won or not.
Well, we reckon you have.
I don't believe it. I'm beating. I don't know what to say, mate. To beat that man is like, hey, I'm wrapped. Yeah. I don't know what to say. I really don't. I'm happy with that. And at a 52, there's a 40 in there in a minute.
Keep it on, mate.
Thank you.
And extremely pleased, Rob D'Emanuel there, Monica. Let's move on to Athol Burns from Victoria for the Greenhouse Superstores lane. About to take on the number one qualifier, Grant Williams, in the Tectaloy Performance Coolants lane.
That's right. Now, Athol Burns was actually number 8 qualifier there. So Grant Williams actually ran almost half a second under his index.
Okay, let's keep an eye on the start line there. Athol Burns in the Chevy Camaro. Grant Williams, a red light there for Athol Burns. Grant Williams can take it easy. He knows he's got the race won. Congratulations to you, Grant.
Athol Burns keeps the power on, but he gave it his best shot. Grant Williams records an easy win there, recording a 14.25. Mike Shire caught up with Grant for Mega Power Car Care products.
Well, Grant, still running super well. Reaction time, 0.485. Red light against him there. But you ran a 14.25.
14-second pass, but I won. That's what happens in that race there. The other driver leaves before me, and I saw his red light, and I thought, well, I've won already, so what's the point in...
Why burn it out?
Why push it? So I was smiling. I cruised down the track and thought, oh, it's going to be slow, but I've won.
You've done it.
Thank you. See you next one.
Grant Williams didn't believe he won that race, but let's move on to Enzo Domizio in the Tectalite Performance Coolants lane, about to take on Wayne Robson from Victoria in the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Well, both guys certainly smoke up the rear tyres there for extra added traction in both lanes. Now, Domizio qualified in 13th position, Robson qualified number 6 under his index.
Yes, Wayne Robson has the upper hand in this race. Can he take a win against Enzo Domizio? The lights turn green. What a launch from both machines. Keep the horsepower on. Who's going to take the win there, Monica?
Well, it's going to be a very close run, but Domizio keeps the power on, takes the win with an 8.96. Mike Shy caught up with Enzo for Mega Power Car Care Products, and the crew, they're happy too.
Absolutely.
Enzo, on another one, reaction 5.98, and you ran an 8.96, 148 miles an hour. Man, you're moving.
Yeah, no, that's great. 8.96, we're happy with that. A bit slow on the reaction. Maybe I fell asleep a bit, but yeah, I don't know what happened to Wayne. Apparently he ran out of fuel or something, so thanks to Wayne, it was a good run, and we'll see you in the next round.
Next, Wayne.
Thank you.
Round two eliminations there in Superstock for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy, and Geoff, what about Bob Sherry, the local boy, doing very well?
Yeah, he did extremely well over that very beautiful Pontiac, as we talked about earlier in the show. But the guy that impressed me the most was Rob DeManuel from Western Australia. Long toe for the guy. Took out Les Hines. Very impressive.
Great to see him make the trip. Now, what about Enzo Domizio? Still winning?
Yeah, Enzo, very excitable character, should I say. Actually, our camera guys will not even get in front of that car when he does a burnout. He's a wild man. So, great to see him get through, though.
We'll see how far he goes a bit later on. We'll take a break here on Drag Racing today, but when we come back, we go in search of purchasing your first drag racing race car.
Oh, what words from these guys. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for these two gentlemen down here. Come on! They put on a fabulous display of drag racing for Adelaide International Raceway.
Well, earlier in the show, we saw Victor Bray and Brett Stevens in a match race. They've done it again. Here they are once more, and round three of Superstock action for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy.
That's right, Bruce. This is the Greenhouse Superstore's Top Door Slammer match race number 2 with Victor Bray and Brett Stevens.
And the Burnout Kings are back at Adelaide International Raceway. Nice to have these guys back here once again, Monica. Brett Stevens leads this match race 1-0. So let's find out and see if Victor Bray can match him. Going to be a tall order. There's Marie Bray just making sure that the door is closed there for Victor.
And the enormous crowd out here tonight at Adelaide International Raceway, Michael, enjoying this superb performance from Victor and Brett.
Yes, the crowd get up on their feet to witness this pairing coming up. Can it be Victor Bray or Brett Stevens? Both coming into the start line area, waiting for the green light. Ah, big red cherry for Victor Bray, an automatic 2-0 win going to Brett Stevens.
Mike Shy caught up with Brett Stevens for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Well, Brett, a pretty good reaction for you. A 4.36 as you took off, then you ran a 6.79 for 208 miles an hour. How did it seem for you?
Well, we got our tyres shake back.
Yeah.
That left lane, it's, you know, out about probably 150 feet to 300 feet, it shook pretty bad. I don't know what happened there. I seen the both stage lights come on and Victor took off and then said, I think he got a red one. So.
Yeah, well, it looks as though he went shopping early.
Yeah, oh well, put that one down. But I think now, you know, the third one, we'll run back in the right lane again and we'll try and run some big numbers tonight.
Okay, well, it's going extra well, thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Victor, that was an unusual one. The lights didn't even trigger for you at the start.
Yeah, I don't know what went wrong down there. The guy held us on the line a while, whether it's not clicking off or what, I don't know. But car ran straight, went down the middle of the lane, and that was the main thing we were looking for. So we'll go out on the next one. Hope the clocks will work this time. We'll get a number out of it.
Well, we could see that it was a very quick run anyway.
Yeah, I'll know how fast it is when I go back down and download the computer. But it was fast. It was real, real fast. It would have been in the high 229s, low 230 mile an hours, and a little bit nerve-wracking here because of the short braking area, but it's a shame to do a run like that and the crowd on the hill don't get to see how fast it was, but I can assure you it was fast, real, real fast.
We know it.
Thank you.
And now it's time for round three of the Tectaloy Eliminations Ladder for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy. Now the first pairing is Grant Williams, number one qualifier on a bye run.
Yes, well, they're the Grant Williams. We see Tony Schiavello from South Australia taking on Rob DeManuel from Western Australia.
Also Bob Sherry and Enzo Domizio. And now the first pairing for round three of Superstock. Rob DeMamiel from Western Australia gets all crossed up here in the burnout in the Tech Deloy Performance Coolants lane. And now Tony Schiavolo running the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Absolutely, Monica. Now Rob DeMamiel coming all the way from Western Australia. He really wants to make this one count. I can tell you now, up against a very strong competitor, Tony Schiavolo from South Australia.
Okay, the guys coming into stage now. Schiavolo number 7 qualified, DeMamiel number 11. They both ran under their indexes in qualifying today.
This is going to be a very tight race. The light turns green for Schiavolo. Keep an eye on DeMamiel. What a launch! A superb launch coming out of the Western Australian. Can he take a win?
Very, very close towards the finish line. DeMamiel does take this win, though. He runs an 8.52 at 2.53 kilometres per hour. Now let's have a look at the Tech Deloy slow motion replay.
Yes, we see Rob DeMamiel pouring on the horsepower. Tony Schiavolo's got the throttle wide open, but it is here that he takes the win. Congratulations to you, Rob.
Rob, we weren't quite sure there who won, but Tony just came up and he realised that you took out the win. 5.17 reaction, 8.52 for the run.
I don't believe that, mate. Again, as I say, like, that was a heaven run. I had a hair of burnout up there and my steering wheel fell off of me before I staged and it stalled and I went, oh my God, that's it for me. And I won. I can't believe it. It's just awesome again, mate. Out here at Adelaide too.
Congratulations.
Thanks, mate. Beautiful.
An absolutely ecstatic Rob DeMamiel. Unbelievable. Now we've got Enzo Domizio once again getting crossed up in the burnout.
It's all happening in Superstock Eliminator here, Monica. And as you see, Bob Sherry really smoking up the rear tyres in the beautiful ASV Holden Commodore. He's got a very strong competitor beside him. Enzo Domizio would love to put away the experience of Bob Sherry.
Well, Enzo Domizio had a brilliant night tonight. He beat Nick Tsourakis in the first round. He's on a mission, to say the least, running there in the Greenhouse Superstores lane.
Let's take a look at the start line area, a very important part of the drag race. Enzo Domizio would love to put the pressure on board Bob Sherry. Both machines have come in. Enzo is fully staged, waiting quietly on Bob Sherry. Now the pressure is on. A green light for Bob Sherry, a red light for Enzo Domizio, and also in all types of bother.
Well, Bob Sherry takes an easy win in this round of Superstock, goes across the finish line to record a 10.64. Mike Scheid caught up with Bob for Mega Power Car Care Products.
Good on you, Bob.
Yeah. Bob, a reaction 4.69 this time. Enzo red lit against you. You ran a 10.64, 99 miles an hour.
Oh, bad lucky, Red Little. Well, I really wanted to have a good race with him. You know, we're good buddies, but, oh, well, bad luck. Yeah, I backed off, of course, but we're in the final, I think.
You are.
I think we get a bye and we're in the final.
Go for it.
Unreal. See you there.
Well, round three there in Superstock for the Andrew Rowe Memorial Trophy. But, Geoff, once again, the meeting didn't get finished.
No, it didn't, Bruce. Disappointing for everybody, as I said, last meeting, or last show, should I say. But everybody's angry and annoyed, but we just can't do anything about the curfews, Bruce. And when you have as many oil downs and the amount of, when you've watched the show, you'll see how many times the cones were wiped out down the track. Disappointing, but what can we do? We just have to go with what the curfew says, 11 o'clock, all over.
Especially for so many people travelling so far from interstate. All right, that wraps up another season in drag racing today, but what's in store next year?
It's going to be a great year, I believe, next year, Bruce. With this show, thanks to all the people out there that supported the show, it looks like we're going to go even bigger and better next year. We're taking in interstate events and pretty much following the whole series around Australia, so you can expect a lot more from this show.
Thanks, Geoff. Great to have you on the show. Loved your comments. And to everyone who has watched drag racing today this season, it's been fantastic. We've enjoyed your company. We hope you've enjoyed the show. We'll be back next year bigger and better. So wherever you've been watching in Australia, see you next season on Drag Racing Today.
I'm a drag junkie from way back. I love it.
Drag racing.